food is the most tangible culture, and that food defines culture in its very truth and essence. And that's something that nobody can deny. Hi and welcome to From Your Kitchen, a brand new show with Provoke TV. I'm Roma Leishram, and I'm super happy to be today at the home of the Makbools, a Malayali Muslim family in Chennai, originally from Kerala. Let's straight away go into the show. Right now with me, I have Anusha Makbool. I'm going to call her auntie throughout the show. I hope you're okay with that.
Yeah.
So we're going to find out how we're going to make this dish, which is called
Kai Pola.
It's called Kai Pola. That's K-A-I-P-O-L-A. And let's get right into it.
These are the ingredients needed for Kai Pola. This is Nendran banana, the ripe Nendran bananas. I've got 7 eggs, 1.5 cups of sugar, 50 grams each of cashew nuts and raisins, 3 tablespoons of ghee, and 2 teaspoons of cardamom powder.
And what about this, auntie?
This is just 3/4 cup of milk.
How much ghee do you need to put this? Can you be liberal?
We can put little by little and see how much is required.
Okay.
So first I'm going to put 2 tablespoons. I think it's hot. So I'll just start.
Sure. So this is 50 grams of
split cashews. Now this should be the color of the cashew.
So it's not dark, it's not a big roast, it's just a light mellow roast, just that perfume wafting all around this kitchen. Secondly, you put in 50 grams of raisins.
It's done.
Done. And that's it.
Next, I'm going to fry the bananas.
Saute the banana to golden brown color, obviously. We're adding a tablespoon of ghee. This is just to ensure that the banana caramelizes properly.
Once you fry this, you can just put some sugar and caramelize and eat it just like that.
Wow. Okay, so now we've caramelized the bananas to a certain consistency. And auntie, how do you
spread it in?
I'll spread it. How do you figure out that it's done? Like, what is the?
It should be golden brown. It should not get burned.
So now we've finished with the caramelized bananas. We've done the cashews. We've done the raisins.
Now I'm switching off the stove.
Okay, and what is our next
step? Then we'll take the bowl and we'll start beating the eggs.
Okay. You add 1.5 cups of sugar into the beating eggs.
Little by little, we'll add them. Now I'm going to add 1 teaspoon of cardamom.
This is the cardamom and sugar powder that was made ahead. So 2 teaspoons.
Yeah.
And you continue beating. Oh, the smell is to die for. Oh my god, it's so lovely.
Next, we'll add the bananas.
Okay. So now the caramelized bananas will be added into this mixture. We shouldn't call them caramelized bananas. They're just bananas that have been browned to a certain extent. But not, they're not crisp. It's still soft. And you just combine it, okay? So you have 50 grams of cashew nuts and 50 grams of raisins. Just take half the amount and put them in.
Mix it nicely in this.
Okay. So it's important for you to realize that when we're cooking this particular sweet, it should not be on a direct flame. Auntie has used a roti maker of a sort or something like that, but you can use a tawa.
This is, they call it a roti fulka maker or a papad.
Papad roaster or something. The contraptions we have in the kitchen today. So we add 3/4 cups of milk into this mixture, the batter that we already have. Continue mixing the batter. We have no maida, there's no rice flour. That's something that I'm actually really amazed about. It's just bananas.
So that part will be done by the eggs.
Oh, okay. Yeah. So the eggs act like the carb here. So we have a pure protein, really healthy dessert. So then you ladle that gently into the vessel that you're using to cook this particular, let's call it a cake. And you need to stir it?
Yeah.
Is that okay?
No, stirring is done just to spread it evenly.
Okay.
Otherwise the bananas will be on one side.
Now use the remaining cashews that you have. We already used half in the batter.
Cashews and the raisin.
And that's it. So now it's almost done. We've put the batter into a non-stick pan. And now why we're using non-stick is because it's going to turn into a cake in some time. And it'll be easy for us to take it out without actually breaking the cake. But all we have to do right now is wait. As it's cooking, once you see the sides being cooked, switch your flame to a lower flame and then cook it on a slower process. And approximately how long will this take?
It takes about an hour to cook.
Super. At the end, we've put it into that pot, it's cooking. It's going to take around an hour or maybe an hour and a half. It depends on, we have to put it low to ensure it doesn't get burnt. But the magic of television, we already have something ready. Aunty, you already made a wonderful...
Already made one ready for you.
It looks so lovely. And so now I'm going to
this
do something.
This is how it will look like once.
So the final product will look as gorgeous as this. And I know while you all are super jealous, I'm going to have a bite of it right now, Aunty. Let's give this a taste. Oh my God, that is absolutely fantastic. It's one of the richest things I've ever tasted. I can't believe that there's literally no maida or flour or anything that's gone into it. It does not taste eggy at all. There's this lovely richness that the ghee gives to it. It's sweet, it's rich. I would never believe this is made with banana and eggs, believe me. And I don't think anyone could eat more than a slice of this because it is so, so rich. I'm not sharing it with you.
You've learned it.
Yes, I love it. Thank you so much, Aunty. Thank you so much. So this is the beautiful, what do we call it again? I keep forgetting.
Kaipola.
Kaipola. So we've got this beautiful Malayali delicacy.
Malabari Muslims call kai.
Kai?
For the bananas.
So banana is kai and pola is?
That's again a cake sort of
cake. Okay. This is from the kitchens, from the kitchen of the Makbul family. Thank you so much again, Aunty. If you have any recipes that you would like to share with us and you would like to invite us to share some food from your kitchen, then please write to us at the email ID that is showing at the bottom of your screen, or follow us on Instagram, or follow us on Facebook, or follow us on YouTube, and get in touch with us, and we will definitely come to your house and taste something that is authentically from your kitchen.